and welcome to Cultist Simulator. My name is Whisperfire, and we are just about ready to dive into the bump and grind that we were working on, trying to get all of the locations that we could, all of the people into our cult, as much money as we can, and to actually combine all of our lore and knowledge to try to upgrade it as much as possible. And, try to see and how much secret histories we can find in the Manus and how much lore we can uncover. So, let's get back to it. Okay, this time let's try the Orchard of Lights and see what outcome we get. We got Glimmering. Alright. The Sun in Splendor. The hour who once ruled the Manus was known to walk in the orchard before his terrible division. Sometimes his remnants walk here still. Sometimes I see the icy revenants of the Miniscate through the trees or the chiller radiance of the sun in rags. Were they to come upon me, it might be my end. But to see them in the distance is a gift of insight. Ooh, let's do this again. Alright. We need this. Let's go back to the Orchard of Lights for the lore, okay? So, you'll see that this is different this time. Last time we got Glimmering. Now, the hours have been called unmerciful, but they permit sleepers sometimes to walk in the Orchard of Lights, where each fruit glows like a sunset, where the roots of the trees are shaped for peaceful rest, where the mist soothes the heart. I was there last night, and the taste of the fruit lingers sharp and sweet as the passage of spring to summer. And we got pulsating airs, which is an influence, a sixth order, a rising power, a reassuring energy. So we are immediately going back. That should be the last of our books translated, but we do have an affliction to tend to. And it looks like we got 177 funds. But watch, down here, when I click on a card, see how it changes? How did I get that high of a number? I wish I had that much, but who knows? All right, let's study on the Forge lore and see what we need. Study the lore which burns. Very few know that smiths and murderers speak the same prayers. I will examine those prayers. The Smith's Secret. In five continents, smiths have whispered the same words to the iron. Murderers have been known to whisper these words too. And adepts, of course. These words are spoken in ritual to inspire unmerciful change. Okay, it looks like it's going to need erudition in order to do this lore. Okay, good to know. Alright, let's try the Orchard of Lights and see what outcome we get. Ooh. Yes, please. I wanted that. Okay. Last night I walked in the Orchard of Lights. I plucked the fruit, which is always ripe, and consumed it in two bites. The taste is not to be forgotten. As I licked the glowing juices from my fingers, I saw a message carved in the bark of the tree. When I woke, I recorded that message, all I could remember, in my diary. Sweet. We are making some progress. Okay, we are building up on dread, so let's work on that. So we'll take a break. And we are currently studying on reason to get erudition so we can increase our forge lore. All Okay, back in the Manus. Let's do the Lodge of the Sage Knight. Let's see what this influence says. Last night, in the great pavilion above the gray sprawl of the bounds, a woman who once called herself Teresa Gelmer sat on gilt-fringed cushions and offered me a horn cup of dream wine. The wine is imaginary, she explained, but the cup is not. To navigate the Manus, one must understand the distinction. Perhaps one day you'll join me on the pilgrimage, or I'll join you. So here, let us share a secret. And her breath tickled my ear. I think you can summon this Teresa, and she could teach you a language. So even though there are three locations you can go in the Manus per door that you go to, you either stay at the door or you go to one of the two branching locations, the end result varies depending on what card you get. And I do know that if you wanted to be cheeky, you could actually look up on the wiki and you could see all of the card layouts and outcomes. But I actually haven't done that. I'm kind of going by gut feeling, so it makes it more fun. Anyway, we did pass the erudition challenge, so still on our way to upgrading our forge lore. All right. I have increased my mastery of the lore that burns, which we call by its aspect, forge. When we watch a fire, what are we watching for? When we find it, these are the words that it will speak. A word that sanctifies the change that comes when the seared skin peels. All right, let's get another erudition. I think that may be enough to increase this to level 6. Alright, we got another furtive truth. I was actually debating, Yes, I still want to collect all of these secret histories because I'm trying to level them up so that we can get more locations, more vaults to go. Okay. So, yeah, that was stuff that we've already seen before. Okay, we passed the challenge. So, we got a new forge lore. So, we'll go ahead and put that there. A shaping chant. The proper words must be employed when the change comes. Use this right with a knock influence and a bone flute, or other resources of equal power to summon a Caligine. And guess what? This is influence of 6. This is lore of 6. These followers have a lore of 2. So what we can do, I'll grab you. We can upgrade at least the first of our disciples. We won't be able to upgrade everyone else, not until we upgrade our lore anymore, but we could promote a believer by invoking Forge. My follower will kneel as a novice and rise as an initiate. I will administer the necessary oaths myself. All right. It's a start. It's a start. So, I've been looking at the Glover and Glover. We have 100 seconds before we have to go to work every time, you know? So, I'm thinking of sneaking in these commissions and build up some resources of Spintria. So, let's do that. We'll go ahead and grab some of this. Oop. Ah, stay. Okay. Alright, let's do the easiest one first. Commission Grail with this and a little bit of reason. Yes, 60 seconds, 100 seconds. So we can alternate between jobs. We can get some commissions done. That's sweet. I know. Okay, so. I am destroyed. I am remade. Now I sear my skin, and by these marks I shall be known. I pledge myself to the flame, and I shall not flinch from my remaking. We got ourselves a disciple. So, her previous talk, her text, was about she being a shop owner for 20 years and that she had never hired an assistant. Now that she's a disciple, Valkane is not a machine, but we are reasonably confident of that because she has been observed now and then to commit quite human errors. And it looks like she has this weird aspect of potential. She has the mark of greatness. In the right circumstances, this follower might become even more powerful. Possible that we could promote her even more. So, let's see, who's next? Tristan. Tristan says, Tristan dislikes distractions. Tristan dislikes results. All right. We will promote him. Ba-da-bum, bum, bum, ba-da-bum. Ooh, we got over 200 funds. That's good. Okay. Let's see. I'm feeling Orchard of Lights. We actually already read this. About seeing the hours and the fruit lingers and it's sweet in the passage of spring to summer. Yeah, we already got that. All right, I'm gonna try something a little bit different. Well, let's first go back to work so we keep our job and put this there. We're going to again dream the way to the white door. But this time, we have Lantern of Six, and I think we use that to find our way. No. Desire. Desire, huh? Desire or health. Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and read this. This is different. I will start with the first card, and it will divert away. In my dreams, I know the path to the white door. Through the bounds, but that path is thronged with the dead who pass that way. I will need health to resist their chill. The ascent is slow. Winds from nowhere pluck at me. My skin is stained with light. The wood shivers with motion far below. All right, let's see if this does something a little bit different. This time we're using our desire. Okay. In the meantime, let's see what Tristan says. Tristan will do what it's necessary. To create, sometimes one must first destroy. All right, and our third believer. Laid Law has begun to understand the limitations of ingenuity and the power of sacrifice. All right. Kind of curious what this will turn up. All right, we got our work done, so we can do this. This is heart. So, go ahead. Yeah. All right, let's see what the results are. The stag door, a ridged barrier of blood-streaked horn, huge enough for a ship to pass. It was broken long ago, and even now the scars are not quite healed. In a declivity beside the door rests a vast and wounded golden head. Its mouth would be large enough to swallow me, were its jaw not shattered. In its name, Gerby, it begins to intone its riddle. We got the stag door's riddle. What must be opened before the way opens? Answer this riddle to pass the stag door to be counted a no. A no? I guess that's a promotion, like a level. To be counted as a no. Alright. Looking at this, I'm thinking knock lore. And that the lore has to be level 6. But we do not have it. That's a shame. Okay. At least we know. At least we know. Okay. We are promoting the last of our believers. And let's see what he says. Laidlaw has learnt the clever uses of fire and copper, wax and acid. Ooh, okay. So, let's turn in our commission. And while I'm thinking about it, Count Jennings, is it? What's he a tutor of? Latin. That's not who I was looking for. However, the doctor. He's an Aramaic scholar. Let's study with him and pay with Spintria. I know, I probably overpaid, but I'm not waiting. So, let's see what we got. We got iron, Spintria. We'll put that there. And we gotta wait until she cools down before we get another commission. That's fine. That is perfectly alright. But we are going to get another translator. Let's read this. Study Aramaic with a tutor. If I need to learn Aramaic, here's the one who will help. But I will need to pay in Spintria, the currency of the hidden world. This will be sufficient. I'll listen carefully. The language of the visions of Aram, of the book of Daniel, and of the account of Kashnik at the spider's door. And we got a scholar of Aramic, the language of Aram, and all her many children these 3,000 years and more. Sweet. All right. While we're at it, we're going to go ahead and read these translated books. Yeah. Okay. So let's start with our Greek. That is a long, long title. A true and complete accounting of the Alcopin mysteries of the roots of the house. Descriptions of the Alcopin mysteries reproduced by one Re-Greece from supposedly a much older text. It's unlikely to be genuine, but it makes a reference to the house without walls and its wood, right there in the prologue. All right, this is very obviously not an antique text. At the very least, it has been badly mutilated, but it contains substantial, intriguing material, especially a persuasive comparison of the many portaled house without walls to the human body. The direction of death is down, the book explains. The peacock door has been considered a rent or an abrasion, but in some respects is more like a mouth, if not a more treasured point of entry. Discussions of the doors include a rite which may conjure creatures through these doors, although key incantations are missing. Rite of the map's edge. The vagabond is the only hour that never enters the Manus. This rite must be performed in the right place, in the right time, and the vagabond will take the rightness for her own. And we got words that walk. Alright, let's go ahead and take our right. We got 4 rites. I think there's 5 of them. So, we'll take that. and the next book. Dun dun dun. Read the volume of Orchid Transfigurations. The Orchid Transfigurations, Volume 2, A Birth. The second volume of a compilation of a quasi-Rocarian allegories, supposedly by Roderick Flood. This is a later English translation. Flood, or the Pseudo-Flood, suggests alignments between the alchemical tradition of Rudibull and the older Grail traditions through the Pine Knight's quest for the Cinnabar Cup. Seek the cup and the birthing bed, the Pine Knight is told. The midwife at the birthing bed, to his amazement, is the Mountain Mother. In a fit of awe, he both gelds and flays himself. The vigilant storm bursts joyfully from the remains. Ow! Dang! How can you do that to yourself? Just snip, snip! Alright, next book. Study the Bells Morium, an 18th century epic poem by the pseudonymous Solophistos. The poem elliptically describes a war between beasts, weather phenomenon, and arcane concepts. It's quite specific about their tactics. The two, one joined, and the horned distinguished. Consequently, blood. That's a little cryptic, but we did get some edge lore. We were lacking in that, so that's good. All right, the last book that we have in our arsenal. An occasionally coherent catalog of the secret gods. This is an English translation of a volume dealing with the powers of the wood. The volume deals mostly with the hours of the wood, the moth, the black flax, and the ring yew, among others. What's a ring yew? Okay. Uh-oh. I went to the Odysseus Club to get some contentment. Let's read this, okay? Which the outcome says, an interruption. Okay. The entrance is lost beneath soft drapes of crimson, cinnabar, and nectarity. Above the door, the club motto, In green rom imis nocte e consumi mir inogi. It has been rendered, Into the night circle we fly, until the fire enjoys us. The performance has hardly begun when a moan of terror arises from the audience. The performance ends immediately. The lights come up. We are ushered from our seats and urged into the street. It's never clear what has happened, but the club staff seems prepared, as if this has happened before. Lights bloom in nearby windows, and passers-by gulp at the crowds of guests, dispersing into the night. Oh, snap. We are in trouble. But... Alright, how long? $2.99. How can I get rid of notoriety? What can I do? Maybe... No, that's Grail. How about a heart? Yeah. Clovet. And charm. Not everyone is sympathetic to our aims, but if we have problems with our reputation, our believer might be able to soothe them over. Okay. All right. And our commissions, we have done our commissions, at least all that we could possibly do. We could study up on this, but we already got level 6. However. Alright. We need to do something with this. somehow we need to get rid of that notoriety. Or we could just let that lapse, take some time off from work. We could take a break. Yeah, okay, I got it. Oh, wait, never mind. It sucked up the notoriety. Never mind. Okay. So, we got that. Got the furtive twoof. I know, I said it very silly. And I think we'll be alright. Out of curiosity. Okay, we got a season of ailment or affliction. This dread's gonna go bye-bye. Thank you, detective, for getting rid of that notoriety. Alright. So, we got that. This was going to get up some reputation, but the RNG gods were kind. Okay. Let's see. I think this is erudition? Yes. Okay. A peculiar rumor? That is fine. Okay. We did some investigation. We got the white stag door. We got the stag door's riddle, which I am thinking this is knock. But we can do a little trial and error. So. Alright. In my dream, I don't think I have the answer. Yeah, this says this is not the answer. So yeah, we could just simply do it like this, but I think it's useless without it being a level 6 lore. But next time when I do this, I will definitely read the first card. But at least it tells you in advance. Oop. But I am certain it has to be a level 6 lore. And my guess is that it's knock. Okay. That is fine. I don't want to risk a follower, because if they fail, I could lose the follower. So I will let that burn. I will just let that just simmer. Wow, I'm stammering. Okay, what I am going to do, I'm going to go ahead and take a cut here, take a break, and edit the footage and see how long this episode has gone out. But at this moment, we have over 200 funds by keeping a low profile. We had a close call with the event at the Odysseus Club. We studied through all of our books. We studied through all of our lore. We have explored the white door and read all of the lore. And we got the stag door's riddle, which I am pretty confident that it is level 6 knock lore, which we don't have. So let me make a quick timeout, check everything, and see what's up. I am back, and I decided to take all the footage, better part of 2 hours, and make it into a two-part episode type thing. And I'm sitting here thinking about what I should do next. Aside from turning in the commissioned work, I'm thinking we have enough lore. We could probably do a try-hard approach and study the last of this lore, kind of like crunching it down. But sooner or later, we're going to have to take a break from Glover and Glover and go on these expeditions. Because I do know that at the conclusion of these expeditions, you will get notoriety. And I kind of want to keep the job. So there's nothing wrong with taking a quote-unquote extended leave of absence. So, we're going to take this, pop it in there. And also, as a backup, while we're not working, we can continue working on commissions, you know? I'm not going to dig into the vaults just yet, because I kind of want to save it for a new day, a new episode, because I'm actually kind of worn out, tired, pooped. You know the whole spiel. So, yeah, I think, what am I doing? Oh yeah, we were trying to do the riddle, which we probably will not, so we're going into the crowds of sleep. The head is silent, the door remains closed. Now I drift into other dreams. All right, we got bronze, and we gotta wait for these to cool down, but that's perfectly okay, I think. Yeah, we could squeeze it right in there. Yeah, that would squeeze it nicely. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Okay, fast forward. A forgotten chronicle. All right, we got four of these. We need just one more before we can find all of the locations of the continent, you know? So, let's see. I want to hang on to it until I am good and ready. Okay. Yeah, I figured we get restlessness, but we got contentment. All right. Tonight is the dream of the labyrinth of doors. I dreamt of opening doors, red doors and gold doors, and doors of glass and doors bound like books and railway carriage doors and castle gates. Behind the one was the something I seek. I woke with the slamming of doors still in my ears. So, all right, Glover and Glover. All right, let's take care of our affliction while we're at it. Keep doing this to keep up the funds. And maybe, just hoping. Yeah, I was right. Just need a little bit of glimmering. Okay. So we are just about finished with our task. Okay, yep, that should take care of it. We still got the tentative evidence, and we will for quite some time. But at least we are still good with Glover and Glover. Oh, this study is going on and on and on. Let's pick up some new commissions. Mm-hmm. What do we got? We got very substantial moth. Good thing we have lore for that. Yep, we could do it. Which means it's going to be very profitable. Okay, we got that. Ba-da-bum-bum-bum-bum-bum. And we're going to need a little bit more glimmering before trying the wood whisper again. We got very substantial heart. All right, let's see what the good doctor wants for us. And we got very substantial lantern. We can do all three of these. We just can't do knock. That is frustrating. I I did a little bit more grinding, took a few more trips to the Mansus, and we actually got Tier 6 Secret Histories Forgotten Chronicles. We have enough to discover all of the locations on the continent. But if you look at our funds, you'll see that we have over 300. So I think we have finished what we set out to do, which was get all of the believers, as many commissions, as a handful of locations, building up our resources. I think we are ready to go into the next phase, which is now mounting expeditions. Thankfully, we have no evidence and no notoriety against us, which that will change. So to protect the job, we're going to go ahead and let the Glover and Glover board seat position expire. Let it sit. We'll suffer a demotion, but I think that is perfectly all right. So I think I am quite satisfied with this grinding process of gathering our resources. I think we are ready. So I'm going to wrap it up here. Hope you guys enjoyed the two episodes, the part one and part two of this session of just getting everything out. So be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and share. This has been Whisperfire, and I wish you an awesome day. Oh yeah.